Hi, Olivia. I will. All right, there we go. And we'll start in a little bit. I'm just gonna wait for a bit more people to join, so you can just talk a little bit. Hi.
Hello.
Just make sure that this is. All right. So we'll wait for some more people to join. We'll wait until, got a time zone here. 5, me 6, you 5, right? Okay. I always get so confused about time zones sometimes. I was so good when we did MTA. I was like, okay, I know it's an hour earlier. It's an hour earlier. And then I totally forgot. Yeah. And now I'm like confused because there's people who live in LA who are doing these, and there's people who are living like different places, like so I'm so used to different time zones, and sometimes I get confused because I'm like, wait, which time zone is it again? Oh yeah, hour earlier, or 3 hours earlier, or some hours later, whatever. But yeah, for me it's almost 6 o'clock, for you it's almost 5 o'clock. Okay, so keep that in my mind. So I don't know if you've watched any of my other cabarets, but what I do is 15 minutes of questions, then you perform, and then we do, like, the time remaining, more questions. So, cool. So I'll just have you, like, slate, because last time I forgot to ask Sammy, because Sammy was earlier. Forgot to ask her just late in the beginning, so I'm gonna just have you slate, like, name, age, where you live, and fun fact about you. If you don't want to answer any of those, you don't have to.
Well, my name is Olivia Feldmann. I am from Muskego, Wisconsin. I am 15 years old, and a fun fact about me is I auditioned for America's Got Talent a few years ago, but didn't make it past the first audition process.
I think you told me about that actually once. That's really cool though. I would love to audition for America's Got Talent. I probably wouldn't make it, but sometimes they just like, because I think it's like for those shows, sometimes they like pick specific people, even if they're bad, they just pick specific people who they want. Sometimes they think you're very talented and they're like, you know what? Nah. Next. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's really fun, but it's hard.
Yeah. Did you do dancing or sing?
Sing.
Because you're a ballet dancer?
Yeah.
Do you do any other styles of dance or just ballet?
What is included in our ballet, like, time thing is we have jazz one day a week, and then we have Pilates one day a week, but mostly it's ballet.
I did ballet when I was younger. I still do, like, you know, the basics sometimes. I don't do it anymore, but I really want to because I really like it. I love ballet, actually. It's one of my favorite styles. A lot of people don't really think that about me. Some people think I like hip hop and stuff, which is weird. But hip hop is one of my least favorites.
Same.
I did hip hop for I did hip hop when I was little, and then I did it for a couple months over quarantine, and I was kind of bored. Let me move this back a little bit.
I did hip-hop when I was younger. I also did tap when I was younger, and I really enjoy tap, but I never really had, like, any good experiences with where I went or the teachers that were teaching or something like that. I just kind of stopped and pursued ballet.
Yeah, I also did tap. I think I did ballet, jazz, and tap, I think. And then did I do hip-hop? Maybe I didn't do hip-hop. I did hip-hop later on, I guess. But when I was little, I did ballet, jazz, and tap. And I loved all three of them. I did it for maybe 6 years or 5 or 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
like those baby classes that you put in. Like I was like two, maybe, or one or two, probably two. And I did it for a while, and then I stopped because they were gonna move me on to a higher team that was like multiple times a week. But my mom couldn't do it at the time because my mom was working, like she was working too much, so she didn't know how she would get me to classes. So I started gymnastics instead. Story of my dance.
I tried gymnastics, but it just really wasn't my thing. So
I feel like whatever I do, I somehow find a way to like it. I have like a really open mind, I guess. Whenever I go to do things, like I try, well, except hip hop, I guess. Hip hop, I was just like, you know what, I don't really like this. But everything like I've tried, I would say I like it, but I wouldn't say like, oh my god, I love it. Things that I would say, oh my god, I love it, were for like singing and acting and dancing. So that's why I stick to that. I like gymnastics. Well, actually, back then, I loved gymnastics. When I did gymnastics, I loved it. I still like to flip around a little bit. I'm not, you know, amazing. I can't do, like, backhand springs and stuff, but I did, like, you know, simple things, but I still liked it.
I can really only do a cartwheel, so.
Yeah, I mean, now I can probably only do a cartwheel. When I did gymnastics, the best thing I could do, I guess. Like a front hand, a front walkover, or like a back walkover. Those were like the best things. I was able to do a front handspring on the trampoline. That was like my biggest flex back then. Like I can get on a trampoline do a front handspring. I am amazing now.
I did a summer of trampoline gymnastics, and I liked that better than normal gymnastics.
Yeah, so. I love trampoline gymnastics. I did. I would spend time on the trampoline when I was in gymnastics, and I would, like, ask to go on the trampoline. They'd be like, no, we have to go to this place. I was like, oh, man. And then I stopped doing, like, the basics in gymnastics. Like, I stopped going to bars and beam and vault and that stuff, and I just did tumbling. That was interesting. I liked it, of course, because why not? But I do kind of miss going to, well, back then, I don't do gymnastics anymore. But when I did tumbling, I did miss, you know, bars and beam and vault and that stuff. Not that I was good at it, because I wasn't. But, I guess my main goal was to get a back handspring. Never did, but.
Yeah, no.
Not good. I tried. Yeah, so we can start. I'll ask you some questions, and if anyone has questions for Olivia or for me about the cabaret, you can put them in the comments. I have my paper. Since you're a dancer, that kind of helps my questions a little bit. Not that I have any, like, basic dancing questions, but I can kind of, like, make things, like, you know, like, for example, like, favorite thing about acting, I go, what's your favorite thing about dancing? Or what's your favorite thing about singing? Like, it's a wide variety of different questions. But I'll start off with something easier. Like, what's your favorite color?
See, I get asked this all the time. And my favorite color is actually my birthstone. But everybody's like, that's not, like, a color. Choose a color and stuff like that. So if I had to choose a color, it would be blue. But, like, my favorite color is my birthstone, which is opal. So.
I have to look up that color. I've never heard of it.
It's like a white stone, but it's got, like, a rainbow effect inside of it. So.
That's really cool. That would be, like, I love, like, those kind of, I don't know what my birthstone is. I think it's blue, but I'm not 100% sure. Probably not. I don't know. I don't pay attention to that stuff. I should, but I don't. I have to search that up after this, see what that looks like, because I think it would look really pretty based on how you described it. Great. Yeah. This one. Okay. So I'll just ask favorite animal.
Wolf, definitely.
Yeah, I love, well, wolves, like, were dogs, I believe, back then. And they kind of, like, breeded into, I don't know, science, biology, who knows. But, I love wolves. I think, they're brave and they're super. Yeah, I think they're cute. A lot of people are like, they're scary, but I think they're cute.
Yeah, both my aunt and I, we both like wolves, so.
I think back when I was in like first grade, there was this kid who was like, I can make you all werewolves, and every time you see a full moon, you will become a werewolf. That was my elementary time. There was one kid who said I can make you a fairy. There's one kid that said I can make you into a werewolf. And me being a hypocrite, I believed them. Yeah, that's me. First and second grade me. All right, so let's get into more like performing questions, because those are kind of just, simple one answer questions. What is your dream role? I know it's a hard
Do I
question.
have to choose one, or can I like say a whole bunch?
You could say a whole bunch.
Okay, so definitely my first dream role would be Victoria the White Cat from Cats. That was the first musical I was pretty much ever introduced to, and I fell in love with it ever since. I would watch it like every single day of the week, and my parents would get tired of it, but I never did. Another one would definitely be either Anne Boleyn or Catherine Howard from Six. I just recently got into Six during quarantine because, what better to do with your time than get introduced to new musicals?
Definitely.
Probably either, I also like Lydia and Wednesday Addams. I think even though they're like main characters of musicals, they're very like underrated because they're more of like the darker, I don't know, kind of characters, and so a lot of people like the more upbeat characters. So that's just a few of them, but I have a lot more.
I don't know why, but my mouth is like so dry today. But anyway, that are like all of those are my dream roles, and I totally understand it because like every time someone's like, what's your dream role? I'm like, can I name like my 100 dream roles? Or totally get it. I have like a million, and I love Lydia and Wednesday Addams. Those are like my two my like one of my well my dream role one of my biggest dream roles is Lydia in Beetlejuice, and Wednesday Addams, but my one of my biggest is Lydia, because I love her, and I do think she's a little underrated, but I think that with Beetlejuice kind of getting more popular over time, especially since they closed, a lot of people are listening to the soundtrack more often. It's a lot of people's dream roles now. It's mine, definitely. And it's such a good character, I think. I like playing the darker characters. I like to be kind of mean, but I also like being like, bubbly. Like, the Girl
Yeah,
Scout is kind of
definitely.
fun when you sing the Girl Scout song in Beetlejuice. That's fun to sing sometimes because it's like upbeat and fun.
It's weird because like in like person, if you were to meet me, I'm like super bubbly, and I make friends really easily. But then you get to know like my dream roles and the musicals that I'm into and stuff like that. Then it's like a completely different side of me, and it's really weird because I get into ballet and I'm like the soft kind of like elegant person, and then you meet me in real life and I'm like super bubbly and happy all the time, and then like my musical dream roles are the more darker like underrated characters, so it's just like I don't know.
I'm kind of like the same way, because if you meet me in person, I used to be super, super shy, And then when I got more into musicals, I started becoming more outgoing. And but then my dream roles are like the mean people, and I've just never like the mean and underrated characters. Not even mean, but like dark characters. But I feel one of like a role that really spoke to me was when I saw Descendants for the first time, and Mal in Descendants. I felt like that would be so much fun to play Mal, because she's like, she doesn't know herself yet. She doesn't know she wants to be good or bad, and I feel like that character is someone I would love to play, for some reason. But I totally understand what you're talking about. Like, my dream roles have nothing to do with me at all.
No.
But then again, that's the fun of it, because like you can be when you do musical theater, that's what's so fun. You can be the total opposite of who you are. So.
Yeah, I can relate to that right at the moment. Because of my school's musical, we're doing Les Mis. And so the character that I got is the complete, total opposite of what I am. And it's something I never imagined, like, ever playing in musical theater. But, like, I'm just gonna go out there and be the best person that I can be.
I would love to be in Les Mis, though. You're so lucky. I've never been in Les Mis before. It's one of my favorite shows. I would die to be anything in Les Mis. It's an amazing show.
Just like to be in the show itself is, even if it's like the school version of the show, it's still like a big accomplishment because that's a very, very well-known show. So, yeah.
Definitely. You should be really proud of yourself, because especially since it's a school performance of it, because schools can be very tough. They could be like, they can like want specific people for specific roles and then just kick you right out if you don't, you're not that kind of person that they envisioned. So, yeah.
Yeah. But then again, like, they can envision you as like one thing before you audition, and then once you audition, they're like, oh, they're perfect for this other role. So it's like, it's a lot of going back and forth. I know last year was a really hard year for me because I auditioned for like as many things as I could, and I like didn't get anything last year. I mean, yeah, I was a freshman in high school, so I was like still getting used to all of the things. But it's hard because when you're like in middle school and you're auditioning and auditioning and auditioning and you're getting everything, and then you go into a school expecting to get something, but you don't get anything, it's especially hard. I'm a huge perfectionist when it comes to anything. So it's like I know it's for the experience. Like, I do it for the experience, and if I make it, I make it. If I don't, I don't. Either way, it's gonna go one way or the other. But it's still like heartbreaking when you don't make it, when you think you're gonna make it, and then it's like shocking when you make it and you didn't think you were gonna make it. So it's like a 50-50 shot.
Yeah, I definitely understand. Like in middle school, it was like a little bit rough for me, because I didn't really audition for anything, because I was kind of going through a little bit of a rough time. And then when I got to high school, I started auditioning, and yeah, it's hard because you're thinking to yourself, "Oh my God!" Like, well, in middle school and in elementary school, even though I was going through a rough time, I did get some roles that I, didn't expect to get. And then when I got into high school, it was definitely way harder, because you're older, you're more mature, there's more mature kids around you auditioning for the roles. People take it more seriously, especially since they know college is in a couple years. And
Yeah,
some kids wanted you for college, so, like me.
they usually cast like the seniors more than anything because they know that it's going to be like their last show and they need something like big or something like that just to like remember before they go off into college to do whatever they want to do. So I completely understand that. My freshman year in high school, our musical was Beauty and the Beast and I auditioned, but I didn't know like what to expect. So it definitely wasn't my best audition. Like I know I could have done better with my audition that I did this year. So like just going back and reflecting on past years, thinking what you could have done better is just like yeah, it's hard if you don't make it, but then you can go back and reflect and think, okay, why didn't I make it? And then just like get better from there. So it's like
Yes, there are so many auditions where I go back and I'm like, why did I even do that? Like, that was so wrong. Why did I even audition with that? But it's like you do it and then you learn from it. Like, I've learned so much in the past year, honestly, from quarantine. Then I've learned so much about auditions and about things, and then I go back and like relive, well, not relive, but like think about what I did in past editions. And I'm like, oh my God. Obviously, I wouldn't get it because you just took a wrong turn, like from the beginning. Like you didn't even do the right thing. So I totally
And
understand.
especially with MTA, that like especially helped this past summer, because like there's a lot of people there that wanted to do the same thing that you wanted to do, so you felt like very comfortable when you're going into like a high school audition and you see so many seniors there, you just get like so overwhelmed. And so doing MTA, it was really nice because I didn't have to worry about getting overwhelmed. Everyone there was pretty much like a family, and we were all talking and stuff like that. So it just felt really nice. And knowing that you don't have to go into something overwhelmed when you don't know who you're going it into it with. Because with MTA, we didn't know anybody, but we all became so close. And that's pretty much what like a musical family does.
It was amazing. It was if anyone watching now, it is 6:18, so I'm gonna have you perform in a minute, but we did go over a little bit, but well, not over, but over 6:15 or 5:15 for you. But what we are talking about is that Olivia and I both did Music Theater Academy over the summer. It was a virtual musical theater, music theater. I was getting confused with musical theater and music theater, but it's a virtual musical theater camp that we did over the summer. It was a week, and it was amazing. We met so many people, and we got to do workshops with, we did master classes with the current Carlotta in Phantom of the Opera on Broadway, and some. A sixth, what was it again? I forget. The
The
producer
producer
of
of Six
Six,
on
and then
Broadway.
a graduate of I'm blanking on the school. She like she
I know, same.
wait, it's in New
It was
York.
a music theater college in New York, but I can't think of the college itself.
It's literally like one of my dream schools, and I'm blanking on it. Wow, good job, Carly. I'll think about it. Like, I'll come back on after Olivia performs, and I will tell you guys what it is because I will just like hit myself out of the screen right now. Not really, but like I'll just like remind myself in like a second when I leave, and I'll just remember it. But so
It
yeah.
was NYU Steinhardt.
Oh yeah, on NYU. Yep. Thank you. I can't believe I
You're
forgot that.
welcome.
I literally it live in New Jersey, and NYU is probably my biggest dream school. So good job to me. But yeah, Olivia, I'm gonna have you perform now, and we can talk a little bit more about Music Theater Academy after. And yeah, because yeah, I'm gonna step out so
Cool.
I can watch you, not me. So I'll be right here. You can perform.
Should I say what I'm performing?
It's totally up to you. You can if you want to.
Well, I will be performing Hallelujah, the most well-known one that is also sometimes played on the radio during Christmas time. If you're not sure which version it is, it's that one. A secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. The baffled king composing, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from the lips she drew the hallelujah. 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 I've been here before. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. You know I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen you playing on the marble arch. And that is love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, there was a time when you let me know what's really going on below, but now you know. Show that to me, do ya? But remember when I moved in you, and the holy dove was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Sorry, I got, the music was going out a little bit, so I was confused if it was done or not. Technology is so much fun. But, yeah, great job. That was really good. I have a quick question for you. It's 626, 526. Do you mind? I always send out and post the video of you singing. I will send it to you too, on YouTube. And do you mind if I cut a little bit of the intro out?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, because it's a little long and ooh, and sometimes YouTube can be a little annoying. But yeah, I'm just gonna cut it a little bit. I'm not too much, but
Yeah, that's fine.
just so it's not like, super long. But so yeah, I'll ask you maybe one or two more questions, and then you will finish. And this is crazy, but it's my last cabaret of 2020.
Wow.
I will be starting again in 2021. But yeah, thank you to everyone who performed and donated and watched, followed my journey in 2020. And we will be starting fresh in 2021. So yeah, I'm gonna ask maybe one more question because we're kind of running low on time here. But I will say, when did you first realize that you loved to sing, perform?
Well, I think I was first introduced into musical theater itself when I was either 2 or 3, something along those lines. And that's when I started both ballet and piano. I started ballet when I was 2 and a half and piano when I was 3 and a half. So music has always kind of been in my life. I've always kind of just like plunked around on the piano and just kind of sang notes. But I don't think I got fully involved in music until around 4th or 5th grade. That's when I started getting very seriously into music. I've seen musical theater shows before and I was like in love with all of those. But yeah, I don't think I got seriously into music until around that time. If that
Yeah.
makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. I saw my first musical when I was really young too. But I didn't really start, putting myself into musical theater until I was a little older. So yeah, I totally understand what you mean by that. And I'm gonna say one more thing about Musical Theater Academy because we didn't really get to go into it as much because I wanted you to perform before we ran out of time. But pretty much what it is, it's an amazing summer camp, or also they did a winter workshop. So guys, if you love musical theater like me and Olivia and all these amazing kids that are missing it right now, Music Theater Academy is an amazing opportunity. I posted some things about it on my main Instagram. But you guys should definitely go check it out because it was an amazing opportunity. I made so many friends like Olivia and so many other friends that we've made. We are all like in a group chat on Instagram right now. We talk a lot, and it's an amazing group of friends that we've made from an amazing experience that we all share. We all love music theater, and we all love to sing, and it's just an amazing opportunity. So you guys should
Yeah,
go
and
check it out.
even though it was like only a week long, I felt like very connected with everybody who did it. I was very, like I said, I was scared going into it. I don't know about Carly because I knew that there was going to be so many people from around the world, that like, well, not from around the world, but from within the United States and even from Canada. And so I didn't know what to expect because I didn't know if there was going to be anybody that I knew that like went to my school and heard about it or what it was going to be. But I think within the first day, we all became like really, really close. And from then on, we just kind of like stayed together. As Carly said, we have a group chat and we talk very often on it. We like spam the group chat sometimes. But I do think that they are doing a spring workshop, if I heard correctly. I could be completely wrong on that. But if you guys want to check them out, it's just at Music Theater Academy at Instagram, and they have a whole like Instagram account saying what it's about. So
And Kristen and Kaylee are the nicest, sweetest people, and those are the people who run the Music Theater Academy. And I will also, when I post Olivia's thing to JDRF Cabaret, I will link their Instagram there too, so you guys can go check their Instagram out. Sorry, that's my
and point. Everybody who did the master classes was absolutely amazing as well. They were all, everybody was just so nice and welcoming. It was a really amazing experience.
Yep. So the people who they are is Raquel. Do you know how to say her last name?
It's like Raquel Suarez Goon or something like that. Yeah, something like, along those lines.
Yes.
Who plays Carlotta. Carlotta on Broadway.
Mallory Fisher and a little easier to say Mallory Fisher. And Megan Farley. Those are the three people who joined us in the summer, and we love them. They were very nice, and we got to learn a lot from all three of them. So,
yeah. So if you guys, like Carly said, if you are really into music theater and stuff like that, I would make sure to go check them out because they're all very amazing.
Not sponsored. Just kidding.
No.
But yeah, it was a great experience. So that's why we're talking about it a lot, because we both shared that experience together. But yeah, it's 6:32, so it's a little bit over 5:32 for you. Thank you so much for joining. Everyone, have an amazing new year. Have an amazing 2021. I hope to see everyone who performed this year in JDRF Cabaret next year performing again, because it was so much fun talking with everyone. And I do have some special things planned for 2021 for JDRF Cabaret, so stay tuned for that. If you want to donate, the link is in my bio for JDRF_Cabaret and also Carly_Alexa. Gotta say those things. Sorry. But yeah. Happy New Year, everyone. Have an amazing New Year. I'll see you next year. And thank you, everyone. Bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.